Today I'd like to discuss an idea that I've had for a long time that I never really bothered to bring to fruition, which is having a forum where we can centrally discuss all the issues that I discuss on this channel, but more importantly, all the issues that you bring up in the comments section that I'd like to be able to discuss that I don't always get around to. So there are two reasons that I want to take this off of YouTube. The first reason is that half of the time I cannot respond to your comments. As YouTube transitioned into becoming Google Plus, they created all these silly settings, and one of those silly settings that you can have set up is that you can reply to videos, but you can set it up so people cannot reply to you. Now, I don't believe in this setting at all. It makes no sense to me. Again, if you want to have a video and not have people comment on it, I understand that. But what I don't understand is why you should be able to comment on a video and then not allow people to comment on your comments. And most of the time, you have no idea that you have it set up that way. I didn't know that mine was set up that way. So I have to send a private message to half of the people who comment on my channel saying, I'd love to answer your question about the short that you have on pp3v42_g3h, but I can't because your settings are not letting me and I'm tired of sending out this crap. The second reason is that YouTube is not very searchable in the same way that a forum is. So I find myself answering the same questions over and over and over, and it gets a little tiring, and I can't really be a wise ass or snarky and say, use the fucking search feature like I can if I was on a forum, because the search feature to search through comments on YouTube, frankly, it sucks, and you're never going to find the information that you need. So I want to have all this information on a forum, whether we're talking about how to handle one specific customer you have that's causing you a problem, a vendor that's causing you a problem, whether you want to see if you should fire this person, or whether you should start your own business and quit the company you're working at, or you need advice on a motherboard repair. I want there to be a place where we can all discuss this, but when there are central issues that we find ourselves discussing regularly, I can create little stickies to do all the things that you can do with a forum. Now, I'm going to be using somebody else's forum, and I'm going to put the URL right here, or maybe over here. I'm not really that much at editing video, so I'm not sure where the fuck it's going to wind up going when I'm done. But somewhere in this, you're going to see a URL where there's going to be a link to a forum. I'm going to be using the advancedreworks.com forum, and I'm going to try to have all this content and all these questions and all this stuff over there. I'd like this forum to be a home base for my business in terms of the internet presence of the advice that I give out and the how-tos that I have. The reason I'm using somebody else's, I don't want to set up a fucking forum. I don't want to deal with web hosting. I don't want to deal with PHP BB and any of this other crap. I do enough work over the course of my day that again, this is going to be free. This is not going to be paid membership. This is not going to be, you give me 10 bucks, I tell you what supplier to buy from. This is going to be all free advice that I get to in my free time. And I don't mind replying to this stuff in my free time, but I sure as shit am not setting up an infrastructure for it. I'm going to use somebody else's. And the owner of Advanced Reworks is also somebody that I know to be a good guy, that I know to be a good resource if you're in this business. So he has a business called Advanced Reworks where he sells BGA rework equipment and also the parts that you may be using with his gear. Now, the thing about him versus going out and buying the stuff elsewhere, if you're looking for a BGA rework machine or you're looking for some way to, you know, replace graphics chips on laptops or do repairs on game consoles, the reason you should buy from him instead of a lot of these fucktards on eBay is because you're actually going to get some support. Now, if you're buying an HDMI cable, I get why you may spend $10 instead of $30. It's only an HDMI cable. And even if you're wrong, even if you buy something that doesn't work, like I bought this cheap HDMI to DisplayPort cable when I got my 4K TV, it didn't work, whatever, I threw away $7. When you're spending $600, $2,000, $4,000, $20,000 on this stuff, do you really want to make a purchase that's $3,000 and find out that you now have to make that same purchase again for $5,000? Do you want to buy it? Let's say it works. Let's say you buy the $3,000 machine and by some crazy luck it actually works the same way it did the machine that you would have paid $5,000 for from another vendor. Do you want to spend hundreds of hours of time fucking with the thing to get it to work the way you want when you could simply have somebody you call up on the phone and say, hey, this is not doing what it's supposed to, and he actually spends an hour walking you through it? I had one BGA rework machine that wasn't doing the things I want. I talked to the guy, and he tells me I should buy this. I buy it, and I'm having some issues with it. I'm not kidding when I say that I spent 9 hours. I mean, 9 hours on the phone with this guy on a holiday weekend, and he was not impatient at all, and he walked me through all the things I should be doing, all the things I may be doing wrong, to help me with my purchase. That's the kind of thing that I was trying to do when I started the supply company, and that's the kind of thing that most vendors are not really offering these days when they're trying to compete based on price and sell you garbage. So if you're looking to buy one of these things, I strongly suggest that you check out the site. I strongly suggest you check out the forum. I strongly suggest that you pick his brain. And again, I'm not gonna, there's this other board. This guy is kind of like laughing when I say what I paid for this thing. It's like, I paid this much. And he's like, ha ha ha, I paid $4,400 and I got the same thing. And it's like, okay, I don't care. Like 2 days later, I mean 2 days later, there's a fucking thread in this forum where the guy's like, help, help, does anybody know how to make profile for this rework machine? I try every profile that come with and I popcorn all my chips, help, help. And I'm being an asshole here, and I reply to him and I'm like, gee, have you gotten any help from the person that you bought it from? Because the person that you buy it from usually helps you with setting up the profiles if you don't really know what you're doing. I know the guy I bought mine from spent 8 or 9 hours with me helping me set up all the things I needed to get started. Maybe you can have the same done for you. And he's like, yeah, I bought it direct from the factory. So I'm like, exactly, motherfucker, you got sold an easy bake oven. So don't go on and on about how, you know, you got this great deal and I spent too much money. And then 2 days later, go on to say that the thing that you bought, that you saved so much money on, doesn't work. Because I'm going to laugh my ass off at you. Again, I've used that machine to make a couple of $1,000 already. So, clearly, the difference in price between the Easy Bake Oven that you bought and the Zomo rework machine that I bought has paid off. Again, don't cheap out when it comes to spending thousands of dollars. Like, you shouldn't even cheap out when it comes to a fucking Firewire cable if this Firewire cable's intention is to make you money. Don't cheap out on expensive BGA rework stuff. Send the guy an email, see what he has to say. If you don't want to buy from him, great. I'm not going to sit here and endorse the place because, frankly, I don't get paid to. I'm just talking from my experience. But back to the point of the video. If you have questions, if you want to talk about the business, if you want to talk about the board repairs, if you want to talk about anything from the customers to the employees to the vendors to taxes, whatever it is, if it relates to the repair of Apple laptops, of other laptops, of the general devices that we talk about on this channel, go to this forum and let's get some discussion going. And let's create a place on the internet where technicians can talk about the specific field that we work in without having to deal with the crap.